Welcome to my channel, I'm Gary Wiryawan, and today we're doing picture story and review time number 4. Let's go! Picture story and review time. Before we start with today's submission, picture story and review time is actually a new video series that I make where we'll discuss photos together, share photos, learn about them together, and be inspired. The main purpose of why I make this new video series is so that you can showcase your best photographs in this channel, as well as to improve our skills as photographers by sharing together and learning together. If you want to make a submission, please go to picturestory.reviews/submit and fill in the form. You will get a chance to be featured on my next picture and story review video. And now let's continue with today's submission. First submission is by Reverie Photo, and it's this photo right here. It's a photo of a man and a woman on a boat during blue hour. It's kind of like a pre-wedding photo. So the gear that are being used to capture this image are as follows. He used a Nikon camera D810 DSLR, and the lens that was used to take this image is a Nikkor 24-70 f/2.8. And regarding the exposure setting that he used to capture this image, he used aperture of f/2.8, shutter speed of 1/30th of a second, and ISO 2000. Actually, the Reverie Photo didn't tell a lot about the story of this picture, but he said here that it's cool and warm at one photo, and I agree with that. There are actually a lot of things to be liked from this photo that he posted. First, I like the overall composition of this image. I like how centralized the couple is in the middle of the frame. Usually everything is about rule of thirds, but I in particular also enjoy if you put your main object at the center of the frame like on this photo. Other thing that I really like from this photo, as I already mentioned before, is the color. The combination of a warm color created by the light bulbs on the boat, as well as the cool color on the sky, on the background, and the silhouette landscape, and the combination of them really makes a great picture. I personally think that this is a really good example of a pre-wedding photography kind of picture that really looks good on your portfolio. If there are some things that needs to be improved on this photo, well, I don't really think there's a lot of things that you can improve in this photo, but in that case, I would really like to experiment more with the angles. So right now you are shooting right on the same level of the subjects, which are the couple on the middle, but I really think that you could create a more dramatic kind of look by trying to use a lower angle, shooting from a little bit from below, or use a wider lens to capture a really wider landscape, so you can get a lot in the background and emphasize a lot of things on the foreground. Other things that can also be improved is the pose of the subjects or the clothes, or you know, experiment with those kind of things. But I really think that's just nitpicking. I really think that this image is already looking good, and there's not a lot of things that you can do to improve it. So congratulations, Reverie Photo. This is a really good photo that you submit to me, and thank you very much for submitting. Now let's move on with the next submission. And next submission is my image. It's an image of a jetty on Lake Wakatipu in Queenstown, New Zealand. So the gear that I use to capture this image is my already sold Panasonic Lumix GX7 with the Olympus 9-18mm f/4-f/5.6. The exposure setting of this image is ISO 200, shutter speed of 1/15th of a second, and the aperture of f/4. Also, I shot this on a tripod. So let me read a little bit of the story behind this photo. So actually, this photo was taken on Lake Wakatipu on Queenstown, New Zealand, in the morning nearby the hotel that I stayed a few years ago. I particularly love the composition and the overall color and the look of the image. Although it doesn't involve any kind of special technique whatsoever, it is definitely one of my favorite pictures, because not only it is pleasing to look at, but it reminds me of how calm, how peaceful and beautiful Queenstown is. So let me tell you a little bit more about the story of this picture. So first and foremost, that the composition that I use to capture this image is that I try to keep everything at the center. I try to keep the jetty at the center of the frame so that it looks very prominent and very strong in the image. I also use tripod to take this picture to make sure that there's no movement or vibration at all that could cause any blur to the final result of the image. But I think that you don't really need a tripod if you can crank up the shutter speed and make sure that there's no movement and make sure that you are steady, then tripod is not really needed. Color is also an important part of this image. I took this picture in the morning, so there's a combination of blue color and yellow color in the image that makes it really beautiful in my opinion. One thing that's challenging about this picture is the dynamic range. When I captured the image, it doesn't really look like this. It looks like the foreground is completely dark, and that's the benefit of shooting raw. I shoot raw in this image so that I can make sure that I can extract the dynamic range on the raw image later so that I can bring up the exposure of the foreground to make it look like now perfect in terms of brightness and exposure. I specifically like the sky on this image because it looks very blue, it has a little bit of clouds, not too much clouds, just enough to make it look more dynamic. And this just goes to show that Queenstown is really beautiful. I really miss New Zealand, by the way, and someday after this pandemic is over, I wanna go there again and spend some time in Queenstown and make new photographs and explore around more. Alright, so that's my submission. I hope that you enjoyed my picture. So now let's talk a little bit about what we learned from these two pictures today. So here are some important points that I wanna share that I learned from today's pictures. So first point is that sometimes you don't really need advanced technique just to capture a stunning photograph. Just keep it simple. I'm very guilty of trying to use like strobist photography kind of thing all the time just to make sure that I can create a great picture, but that's not necessary. This picture today really shows that with just simple techniques and a lot of creativity, you can really extract a lot out of your image. I really love referee photo submission today. I really think it's a great picture, and it goes to show that you can be very creative with your framing. Just play with your composition, play with your foreground, play with your background, play with your angle, and try to make the best combination of all these three things. Other thing that I learned from today's pictures is that timing is very important. What time you choose to shoot at the day really influence the color and the overall look of the final image. On referee photo submission, you can really see that by choosing to shoot during the blue hour, it can really make a great combination between the cool color and warm color in one shot. And so these are all the things that I can learn from today's submission, and I hope that you can learn a lot from today's submission too. So that is all for today's video. I hope that you learn a lot from today's submission. And if you want to make a submission to Picture Story and Review Time, please go to picturestory.reviews/submit and get a chance to be featured on my next video. Also, don't forget to support my channel by liking this video, sharing this video, and subscribing to my channel down below. Thank you and goodbye.